Action, here we go. Wednesday night, June 8th. Continuing and maybe finalizing the subject of Birkat HaGomel. We're in the middle of Tishu B'Av Bayecham. David Chelouche. We're discussing now if this Birkat HaGomel, if it falls any time, or if there is a minimum travel distance. And so far, the way they're talking over here, you have to travel at least a parsa or more. והרמב"ן כתב שכל דרך בחזקת סכנה ואפילו פחות מפרסה מודח. עד כאן. ולא כן המנהג. על כאן לשון, אורחות חיים, עניין הלכה נראית פחות מפרסה, אלא מברך את גומה כדברי בהלכות גדולות לעניין תקלת הדרך. עד כאן לשונו. חיל פסק בשולחן ערוך וזה לשונו. בספרד נוהגים לברך כשהולכים מעיר לעיר, שכל הדרכים בחזקת סכנה. ומיהו בפחות מפרסה, אלא מברך. ואם הוא מוחזק בסכנה ביותר, אפילו פחות פרסה עד כאן. So basically, שולחן ערוך brings the different opinions and he combines them into one opinion as halakha. He tells you, first of all, in Sefarad, in other words, the Menhag of the Sefaradim within Spain, obviously, the custom is to make the beracha when they travel from city to city because all the roads are considered dangerous. But if it is less than a parsa, beracha is not said. And if this road, even though maybe shorter than a sakana, shorter than parsa, is known to be a dangerous road, then you make the beracha. Nimsa, shel Rambam, lit le shi'ur parsa, lo betfilat ha-derech, velo beberkat ha-gomel, shelo hezkiro be'hilchotav. So the Rambam himself never mentions parsa, not when he talks about the halachot of tefilat ha-derech, or the halachot of Birkat HaGomel. Veramban, according to the Orhot Hayim, sober, Shishi'ur Parsa, who will tefillat ha-derech, ve'lo Birkat HaGomel. Now the Ramban says that this Parsa only refers to tefillat ha-derech, not Gomel. Rabbiya, look at her Shi'ur Parsa, Birkat HaGomel. Rabbiya also does not mention anything about Parsa with Birkat HaGomel. Gam Ba'at Chod Gidolot, look at her Din Shi'ur Parsa, Birkat HaGomel. He also doesn't mention anything about Parsa. ונראה שסוברים בברכת הגומל לא שייך שיעור פרסה. נשים את הסבול אישו פרסה is inapplicable to ברכת הגומל. תראה נפשך אם אין סכנה אפילו יותם פרסה אין מודה. Because listen, be serious with yourself. If there's no סכנה, even if it's more than פרסה, why should you be doing anything? Why should you be thinking? ובמקום סכנה אפילו פחום פרסה נאמה. And of course, if it's less than sakana, of course, who's going to tell you no, not to make the beracha? V'chem ha-shma'a medibreha bit Yosef, she-katab, ke-dibre ma'af hilchot gedolot le'anyan tefilat ha-derech, ve-lo katab ke-dibre ba'al hilchot gedolot setam. Ve-ulam, ke-van she-malchei rabbanan he-binu, ken, u-paska maran le-halakha, nerech le-ora she-em berkat ha-gomel hala al mahalek ba-derech, Pahon Parsa. So basically we say, according to Shulchan Aruch, that if you travel on the road less than the Parsa, you do not say Birkat HaGomel. V'yesh le'estapek b'yamenu sh'rob chol ha'nos'im me'il le'ir, b'chlei reyach mehirim, ma'hu shi'ur ha'derech sh'alev hayyamin b'rach ha'gomel. But now, we're in doubt. What do we do nowadays? Most of the people that travel from city to city, they go in fast vehicles, and you know, by car, by bus, whatever it may be, and things move quickly. What is the shi'ur of the derech that upon which we are required to make Birkat HaGomel? Ra'iti bi Omer, shikatan. Hara mikor hayim hibi ra'ya mashkal pisahim. Tanu lebanan. Haya hous lemodi'in. Ve'yachol ikanez basusim peradim. Yachol yahayab. תלמוד לומר, ובדרך לא היה, והוא היה בדרך. למה אילב קרד ובדרך לא היה? הוא אומר שיהיה חייב קרד, אם יכול להיכנס בסוסים פרדים, ולא נכנס. תחשי מקום קרוב, כיוון שיכול לבוא אלא דגלי קרה שפטור מכוח גזרת הכתוב. ולכן, גבי אבילות, המקרה במקום קרוב, אפילו כמה פרסאות אם יכול לבוא בסוסים. ולאחד דברי השואל ומשיב, שכתב שאין משעירים אלא על פי הטבע, ולא על פי תחבולות שנחדשו בזמננו. שאם לא כן, ישתנו דברי התורה מדי יום ביומו עד כאן. So back to the Gemara in Pesachim. We'll read it again. Tanu Rabbanan. Haya haus l'modi'in. Ve'echol ikanez basusim peradim. Echol yiyye hayab. It's possible that he would be hayab. What about hayab karev? Talmud lomar. Uderech lo haya. Ve'u hayab ederech. Illa ma ilav karad bederech lo haya. Amina shiyye hayab karev. Ime echol ikanez basusim peradim. Ve'lo nechnas. Maybe we're talking about if he could come in by animal, and he didn't come by animal. The Hashib Makum Karov is going to be considered a close place, because we're saying from Modi'in to Yerushalayim is 20 miles. Kevan Sheyechol Labo, Ela Degrekara, Shepatur Mekoach Gizat HaKatu. Now, makes a lot of sense. Velachin, Gabbe Abilut, when we're dealing with Abilut, Makre Makum Karov, it's considered a close distance. Afilu Kama Parsaot, even a number of Parsaot, number of Parsas.
Parsa is equal to...
We're not exactly defining how far the parsa is, but basically it's a distance that you that a man would walk in 72 minutes.
3 miles.
Hmm?
3 miles?
It's about, Yeah. 3 miles, yeah. We can look it up exactly. If it could come by horse. Vedaha debre ha-shoel moshib. And he pushed away the words of the shoel moshib. Shekatavu rot. She'en mash'irin. That we only measure through natural means, through nature. And not through new inventions that were created nowadays. Because if not for that, then the words of the Torah would change on a daily basis. And he brought the opinions of the poskim, both pro and con. Showing both sides. And afterwards he wrote, Nimsa, Shedavar ze talui b'machloket ha'acharonim, I alfinan mepesach, lechol mide dehashiv derech rechoka, af sheyechol ikanez b'susim. It's based upon a machloket of the acharonim. If we base ourselves upon this Pesach, and we use this, reasoning from Pesach, and we use the same distance to reckon everything else, even if you could come in by horse. Or dafka b'Pesach digerekera heba'alma had ba'alma hashiv derech rechoka. But only this refers only to Pesach. Vekevan dekaymalan sefik berachot la'akel. And since, of course, we have the rule of sefik berachot la'akel, en lebarech gomel illa imken. Okay, only make the beracha if the trip ended up lasting at least 72 minutes. Shihu shi'ur hilluch parsa, which is the distance that it would take to walk a parsa. Ad kan debarav. Ve'ayin od, zechul Abraham abigdor, chara'asot, shevi poskim, shelo hizkiram irbiya omer. بينه مشكتها هالشومير إيميت شيش لشعيد اللي فيها التبع دافك شو المشيب يا بينه مشكتها شو المشيب شيش الشعير اللي فيها التبع دافك شملوكي يشتنو دبرها التوراة من يوم بيومه إن تعم زي مخريح بهذاك saying this reasoning is not something that carries any weight in هذاك شببداية التوراة لو تشتن نيل العالمين of course the Torah will not change forever. Then the tenaim, if the conditions change, and the shinui b'Torah, that's not a change in Torah, ella b'tenaeh zeman, but rather within the conditions of the time. Kemo she'en anu makribim korbanot meshehalav mekdash. The same way we don't bring korbanot since the Beit Hamikdash was destroyed. Ve'ata shebatla ha'avodot ba'olam lo mitkayemim dinei abadi shebatla ha'abdut ba'olam. Same way, there's no slavery in the world anymore, so we don't fulfill the halachot of abadim from the Torah. And everything has to fall into its proper time when it's applicable. עכשיו, על פי שהם קיימות אלו בימינו, הם שירים לעתיד, but they're existent and they're waiting for the future when it's time for them. לעתיד לבוא. כשיהיו התנאים ראויים לכך, when conditions are right for it. וכן, באבל, אם נשתנו התנאים, ואפשר לעבור מרחקים בזמן קצר, ויכול האבל להגיע לבית האבל, בימי האבל, מדוע לא יסתרב עליהם והרי הגיע? Okay, the same thing. We're talking about an Abel. Since times have changed, and now he could travel a great distance very quickly, if he could get to the house while they're sitting and he could sit with them and join in with them, what's wrong? He got there, he's sitting with them. And the halakha does not change. And it also applies to those that walk by foot. Then if everybody is traveling by car, let's say, and nobody's going by foot, we have to say that the law has not changed. And it has to apply to the conditions, that have changed. We're saying that the Abel himself, he joins in, and it's Midrabbana and Samidoraita anyway. Vene Pashuchin, the Mohammed Amrina, Mimakot, Amaraba, Bawushinai, Amru, Basura, Safra, Behash Beta, Harakilonit, and Nefish. Ubawushinai, Amru, Pinya, Behash Beta, Imanu Haitim, Bin Hardia. حزينان إم صفراء دفنايا مصير أزيم السوراء دن هردعاء لهفوز وميميم فيلاف هفوز وميميم تشيطة ما هو لتيما دي حوش لقمنا برحا كمش مدام مدنا كانت قمنا برحا بدون كانت سوس وكون نصير أدام أحير مشمع دافك لقمنا برحا دي لا شخيح لا حوششيم أما دي سوس وريخير شكيحي אם יכולים להגיע בהם שאפשר בבוקר היה פלאוני בסורה והגיע בהם לעיר בן הדעה להבו זוממים. Okay, so we all know what the עדים זוממים are, right? Mm-hmm. Right, we all remember? Okay. So basically he's just giving you a case. The guy said, I was here and I saw something happen and people can't know, but I saw you later on, you were in this other city. How could you say you saw this over here if I saw you in the other cities? Because then, the guy went by camel, and the camel, can get him there from, within the same day, for example. It's not a problem.
And this was Shamkad Bur Bimina Hain Perish, Shatam de la Hashinan, the Gamla Perha, Vela Havuzo Emim, Imashi Edim Lota Anu Sheban, Begamla Perha, Adkan. No, but the Edim never said that we came with the Gamla Perha. Demashma, Shekol Shev Shale Hagia, the Makombe, Eze Ofan Shehu, as long as a person can arrive at a place through any means whatsoever, Emer Hakad Dere Hashu Merhak, the distance of that it took to travel is not considered a distance. As long as the people could, reasonably have been in both places, they could have traveled and been in both cities within the same day. They're saying two different times a day. The guys are saying, in the morning we saw this, and the other guys are saying, no, but at night we saw you here. Yes, I could have traveled it in the day. It's not a problem. אבל כאן אנו דנים מה שקבו החכמים מהלך פרסה ופרסאות אם הוא לפי הזמן או לפי השטח. And now over here we have to understand, we have to rule, if this parsa or the parsaot is according to the time or according to the land itself. The space traversed, I guess.
והנה מה שקבו פסחים ובדרך לא היה. והרי היה בדרך. But he was on the way. כלומר, שאין התורה רואה את היכולת של האדם שיכול לבוא ברכב אלא את המסיעות שאותה שעה היה בדרך. The Torah does not look at what the person could have done. The Torah is looking at actuality, at the facts. The fact is that he was still on the road. He didn't make it, period. Yes, maybe he could have made it, but at the moment he did not make it. He was still on the road. ויש להבין, מה בכך שהיה בדרך? So what's the difference if he was there on the way? He could have, arrived. So what's the bottom line over here? Let's say the guy could have come by
by horse, or with another, mode of transportation, or another car, let's say, v'hezid, and on purpose, he said, nah, forget about it, and he didn't want to come to bring the Korban Pesach. Madua lo yitchayev. Why shouldn't he be hayab? Hayab karet, obviously, we're talking about. Umatam sheketub yigzor shi'ur haderech b'regev lo b'rechev. And what is the reason that the ketub should decree of shi'ur of the derech only by foot and not by car? And obviously we have to look and realize this is not a gizera without a reasoning. And there is a reasoning for the mikra. If it's incumbent upon the reasoning that the person has the ability to come to Jerusalem, it would seem that the Torah has only given us its punishments and its commands only based upon certain measurements. Sheish adam shebiyachol to iskursus ogemad ras sheyachol agiya filu merhak shel hamishim parsa dayom. Maybe it has to be in his ability to be able to rent out a horse or a fast running camel that could travel and come from a great distance. Let's say approximately 50 parsas a day. Vim lo ala lehekriya pesach, ye anush karet, lo et haye pesach sheni. No, and if he didn't make it, that's it. He has to get punished with karet, and forget about, being obligated to do pesach sheni. Vizeh she'en beyedu yecholet, ela lelechi beraglev, patu min alo v'yosef sheni. And this guy, who doesn't have the monetary means, he can't rent, he doesn't have the money for it, so he has to come by foot, obviously, he'll make it there, but if he starts traveling the same time Pesach Rishon, by the time Pesach Sheni comes, he'll make it on time, and he'll do Pesach Sheni. Umi sheyechol to ketana, this called Nosei Adam, hayab b'derech shel hamisha asar parsa. And the guy who can rent, well, now he's obligated to go and rent some sort of animal that's going to carry him, and has to go at least 15 parsa, let's say. He's just trying to create, different scenarios for us. Ve'af.
Still talking about Korban Pesach.
Yeah, obviously. Or, he's just trying to bring the whole scenario that we wrote before and to compare it to, does this whole Pesach issue really exist over here and how would we use it? Even the guy who walks by foot, like we said, somebody could walk briskly and somebody could walk, very leisurely. And if we're basically we're only confining the words of the Torah to measure. Then we'll come and say that the punishments and the rewards and the mizvot of the Torah are not equally given to everybody. Everything is different. This cannot be. That's it. It's 15 mil. Shu mahalach adam binuni mehannes hamma at hasot hayom. This is the distance of the average person that walks from sunrise until midday. Hawle was a ken peturim shanusim him. Obviously, sick person or the elderly are patur, are exempt because they're in a different scenario. Umitam zekab obedin abel. And because of this, they established the deen of the Abel, who's coming from a close distance, that he counts together with the other Abelim who are already sitting, and it's the same amount of time of sitting for all of them. And this is, close is talking about 10 parsaot, 10 parsaot, based upon the Rambam, Shulchan Aruch. Sha'ur mahalach adam binuni. The amount of distance that the average person walks, the kevan. Diyu shama' biyomeha nabam masi'ti. That basically, if a person heard that day, he could make it on the same day. Umi'idach imbam makum nahok. And on the other hand, if he came from a distance, afilu toch zeman, even if it's within the same time, munir asmo, he counts for himself. That's based upon the Rosh in the name of the Ra'abad. Mitamze asmo neoma v'rikat gomer d'shi'ur parsa hu lefi ha'shetach velo lefi ha'zeman kedei shelo yomru ننو هخمی دبرهند شعوریم شزه شهدخ برگل پرسای بریخ و حبیروش نسا به افنایم پتور عشی یستا شعور زمان شد مهدخ پرسا. Obviously, we're going to bring this into play with Berkat HaGomel and say, let's say two people left at the same time. This guy went by foot, and this guy, you know, went by bicycle. Okay, this guy, he walked by foot, parsa, yebarech. He was 72 minutes, and his friend went by bicycle. He didn't travel for 72 minutes, you know. When I say berakibet ubemichonit, somebody's going by train or by car. Patur actually says kifle kiflayim menosia berech biti. You know. I'm sorry. What do you want to say, Rabbi Nissim?
No.
Go ahead, please.
No, that's fine.
But so far we're understanding him correctly, right?
Right, I think so. من دين ما شكاب أو شعور برسا لتفلات الدارخ ومركات القومين مشوم
تحوء من برسا كموش هو بعير دينينان له هريش مرحاك هو مرحاك شل شطح ولو مرحاك شل إفشاروت هليخة. Same bottom line is that it is the actual amount of space traveled and not what was in the ability of the person to travel. Correct? Bita'ama the mistabirhu shekushu betof parsa the ayir enu mahuzak usakana. And obviously we understand anybody who's within the parsa of the city, that's not considered dangerous area. She'imat shilton ha'ir al esteem velo ba'im karob la'ir, because the fear of the rulers of the city is still upon the marauders that may be outside and they don't come so close to the city. Aval yoten parsa, but more than a parsa, she'ish hashas takana, there is that chance that, you know, there's a doubt how safe the roads may or may not be. For those that have the reasoning that you're obligated in the beracha if you travel from city to city because all the, you know, the roads are considered dangerous, why would he be patur to, you know, be patur from this beracha if he happened to travel this distance by car? He went through that dangerous area and he was saved. Well, fizin it edi, shiim kishiyaseh kishiyur parsa nichnas betoch kishiyur parsa shel ayir aheret kalomar shaya bin ayir ahad habreta pahom mishti parsa. Let's say between two city is less than 2 parsaot, and by the time you got a distance of a parsa away from one city, you're already within a parsa of the next city.
Right.
Correct. Pahom mishti parsa shein the berachah gomer lechule amma. He shouldn't make Birkat HaGomel lechul ha'am, according to all opinions. Mishum she'en derech zeh b'chaskat sakana kevan she'simucha de'ir m'shin sladeh, because it's considered close to a city from both sides. Af al pi she'b'yameinu nusru kelei recheb m'shuchlalim she'yicholim lehadof et ha'listim miyad afilu b'merhak kama milin afilu ha'che n'ir'e de'la pelug rabbanan kemo she'katabti ve'havadai l'ta'am b'alachai gedulot v'si'ato لا يتود بريه الجاون بي وصيف عبادية شتلاها من حاك بتناهي دي خاتو شلها هوليخ بالدارخ ودليديد هو إم هينو باقين بيامينو لشانوت مدات من حاك هينو كوبعيم شام من حاك تلو بمدات إيمات الشلطون على الاستيم ولو بأفنية ما هذا خو شلها هوليخ بالدارخ. Rabbi Nissim, please try to summarize this for me.
Right, so he's trying to say that this is the opinion of Ovadia Yosef, right?
I'm sorry? He said, "Afal pi she'b'yameinu," even though in our days, all different types of traveling machines, okay, yes, motor cars, obviously, motorized vehicles, okay, have been created, have been invented. All right, and obviously you could outrun any sort of listeem, okay, even a distance of many, many miles. Even so, in the air, it would seem, this is not an issue that the rabbis are, you know, are arguing about, or, you know, that would refer to over here, like I wrote. They have a day,
and just for sure is that in the town of Bahilo, according to the reason of the Baal Chuk Edolot, Visi'atu, and those like him, that this reasoning of Echao Yehi Yosef doesn't fit in at all. What he's saying over here, that the form by the distance of only somebody who is walking on the way. Alright? Is that what he's saying?
Try to figure out the distance here.
One second, let's see what Rabbi Nissim's thinking. One second. عود رأيتي بيبيع عمر. Oh, back to يبيع عمر again. شكتاب. أفعل في شعوبير بأوتوبوس. على فنيها مدبار. شهيا مستكين بو بهلوخ. كأربع كيلومتر. كيفان شو عوبير بمروسة وبدرخ مالخ. أنا سكنا مسويا مسد ستين وحيوان وخيوسة بزه. خجف ناك تاب بورحال حييم. So basically he's starting off, he's calling again يبيع عمر again. He's saying that he saw what he wrote. Even though the person is traveling by bus, through the wilderness, and it would be considered dangerous if the guy was walking, let's say, about 4 kilometers. But since he's going through very, very quickly, and he's on a paved highway and all, there's no sekana, and there's no steam, there's no hayot ra'ot, or anything like that. And, the chai gev nekatab urchot hayim, there's no. Into omar ha'odeh tahat kir natui, v'al ha'geshir, שמזכירים עוונותיו של אדם יברך את גומל אחר שעבר מכל מקום דבר שהוא קצר ואינו ארוך קל לעבור מהר ואינו נחשב סכנה כמו עוברי דרכים שהדרך ארוכה וכמה מקרים באים על דרך ארוכה על כאן שלו והסיק שם שאין לברך את גומל אלא אם כן ערכה הנסיעה שעה והחומש שהוא הילוך שיעור פרסה So over there he tries to compare to this to the Orhot Hayim that says, look, that the guy was walking under a wall that was leaning over on a whatever type of bridge that the avunot of a person recalled over there. Obviously, after you pass through such a problematic situation, you would make Birkat HaGomel. But if you're going a short distance, something that's not long, and it's very, very easy to travel, and you could travel it quickly, and it's not considered dangerous at all, then obviously, what's the big deal? There's no problem over here. And so from this, it would seem learnt out that you do not make Birkat HaGomel unless the distance that you traveled was as long as 72 minutes, which is the time it would take to walk the parsa. This is basically what he's quoting from Chamudia. Now, vehine de breha orhot hayim sirichim biur. Listen, we have to explain the orhot hayim. De mavikach im yose mahim makom sakana, hani makom makom, hayam makom sakana, vini salam im mavet o min nezik. What's the difference how quickly you traveled through this dangerous area? Bottom line is that you traveled through this a dangerous area and you were saved from either death or some sort of accident. Vin ereda has bir, de birkin natui, and we have to explain about this, this slanted wall. Vegesha sakana, or this, bridge of peril. Ahat, he nifilat akir, or tagadir. Or whatever this boundary is, may possibly fall upon you. Kshadam obim hara, and when a person goes by it quickly, nadir shtiye nifilat akir, bidiyuk ben shi'awur ha'adam. It's very unlikely, the chances are slim, that the wall will fall at that very moment when this man is walking by. לכן אין בריך הגומל. Therefore, he does not say ברכת הגומל. וכן בדרך קיסרה, סכנת הדסטים והחיות מועטת. And obviously, on a short distance, the chances of marauders and wild animals is lessened. אבל בדרך ארוכה, in a long way, יש הסטים כאן וסטים שם. חיות כאן וחיות שם. Obviously, you have all types of problems along the way for both sides. והסכנות רבות, ואם ניסול מאחת, Once you may be saved from one, but you may fall under the problems of the next one. Because many things can, befall you on a long trip. Therefore, you make Birkat HaGomel because the sakana is always there, and it keeps reoccurring. And this basically goes according to the shitta of the Rosh that we mentioned earlier on in Teshuvah. They basically were concerned with the whole issue of Birkat HaGomel, were really concerned about animals and marauders. ועל סכנה שאינה מסויה לא מברכים שלא אמרו כל הדרכים בחזקת סכנה רק לעניין תפילת הדרך. And if the sakana, and if the sakana is not to be found, it's generally a way that's not sakana, we do not make a beracha, because anything that we mentioned about when the Hakamim mentioned kol derechim b'chaskat sakana, they were only referring to tefilat haderech, to say tefilat haderech beforehand, to save you from the possibility of this being, you know, derech sakana. But they never refer to, you know, kol derechim b'chaskat sakana, referring to berakat gomer. Ulfi atam azeh, and according to this reasoning now, Timuhim him debrei ha-geon Rabbi Yosef Awadiah. The words of Chacham Awadiah are very, very confusing to us. Shekevan shehanoseya ober derech arucha, shemakrei ha-sakanot rabim ba, lama lo yibarech ha-gomer? If the person is traveling a long distance, okay, and obviously your chances of dangers are many, why shouldn't you say berkat ha-gomer? Uma bekach she'abar otam b'zman kasar? What's the difference if you traveled them quickly? ובייחוד שכתב לנהוג כרמבן וחמרן שכל אוכל דרכים צריכים להודות. And especially since he wrote that we should conduct ourselves according to Ramban and Maran, they say all the persons who travel distances, the way travel the roads, have to give thanks to God. שכל הדרכים בחזקת סכנה גם לעניין ברכת הגומל. All the דרכים also חזקת סכנה also for ברכת הגומל. ועוד, כל שהולך בדרך ארוכה, אפילו שעובר אותה במהירות, anybody who's traveling the way, and even goes through it quickly, חשיב יש בה סכנה, it's considered like it still has danger. כי העורבים הרבים שבדרך יכולים לשים מחסום לסתום הדרך לעצור הרכב, because you have ambushers on the road, and they could put up an ambush, and they could stop your car, and that's it. מי יישב בדרך ומוסף סכנה, and you'll remain on the road in a dangerous position. ואם ינסה מרשת אחת, יש סכנה שיפול בשנייה. And even maybe you may save yourself from one instance, you may fall under a problem of another. ועוד, שלדבריו, הטס לקפריסין, שהוא כשעת יישא פטור. And also, according to his words, somebody who flies to Cyprus, it's only a 1 hour flight, basically he would be exempt from saying the beracha. וקשה! The מכל מקום נראה אם הטעם שמברכים הגומל על הטיסה משום שהסכנה שברכים על הטיסה, if the whole reasoning of we make the ברכת הגומל on the flight because of סכנה that is on the flight itself, אם כן כל שהמרי ונחת חייב לברך. Everybody who was in this dangerous situation, okay, and now he's okay, obviously would be obligated to make beracha, ki keyedu ha-sakana behamra'a benyachita gidona ma-sakana be'aisa ma-nesi'a. Basically, takeoff and landing is more dangerous than the actual flight. And as long as you were able to take off and you landed okay, everything was fine, really, I'm telling you, make the beracha. Bimata'a shemibarachin, mishum shatas me'ali yamim barot. And if the reason is because you travel over water and deserts, imken afilu tazmin zaman mu'ad, even if you're flying in a plane for a short distance, or for a short amount of time, ma'ala yam on bottom, but you're flying over water or over the wilderness, harehu ki yordeh hayam ve'olchim barot. You are like the people who are going down the seas or going across the deserts. Shem barchim, to make the beracha, kevan, she'ilu karak l'kud ba'avirun, because if some sort of problem happened with, let's say, the engines of the plane, or the wings, or whatever it may be, hayan, nuhayat, nehaytat, onet bayyam, and bayyur, take an emergency landing into the seas or into the desert. O shayu an nus'im, nuhtim, بمسنحين بيام, or they would come down by parachutes into the water, ومدبار رحوق يوتن فرسام معير, and you will land definitely more than a parasaf from the city. ولما لو يبرخ قشي يتوش شعب حون, and why shouldn't you make the barakha if you're flying less than 72 minutes? But he's right, people take plenty of short flights all the time. He's telling you, from Israel to Cyprus, people take the flight, it's less than an hour flight. كنت أخان وجاء يوسف, you wouldn't make the barakha.
Well, if you're going over water, you would.
No.
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 The Hamavad, if you're going over water, you don't.
No. The flight was less than 72 minutes.
Well, this whole paragraph.
And then the other one that we learned, didn't he say that it was? Well, somebody said that it was. Planes are not dangerous today.
That was Rahim David Halevi. Yeah. He doesn't want you saying because I don't go on planes either.
Right.
So we follow this.
Do we?
Let's see.
Well, maskana. Let's see. Well, one second. In practice, I think. I'm not the traveler, so.
In practice, you go anytime you get on a plane, you take them out.
Okay, so that goes against the Chamon Yosef.
Yeah, I'm saying it agrees here with
this. Okay. The maskana holkim ahar mahalach bnei adam bechol shi'urei parsaot v'hamilin she'amru hazav velo ahar zeman mahalach parsa telo ke maskanat ha'gaon bi Yosef Uvadiah. Bottom line is we go after what the person traveled and not whether and not after the time it took to travel. And even though now everybody goes by car, when me show this me'il le'ir, alright, holchi mahash, shi'urei ha'parsa, parsao lefi ha'shetach, velo lefi ha'zeman, alright, ben berkat ha'gomel, uben ba'ebel, mishum, shim lo ken, nitat debarecha le'shi'urim. Because if not, then basically you're limiting the Torah and you're changing the laws of the Torah for each person.
Yeah.
למסקנה, הולכים אחר מהלך בני אדם בכל שיעורי הפרסאות והמילים שאמרו חזה ולא אחר זמן מהלך פרסה דלו כמסקנת הגריעה. ואף שבימינו הכל נוסעים ברכב ואין מי שהולך מעיל לעיל, הולכים אחר שיעורי הפרסה והפרסאות לפי השטח ולא לפי הזמן. Goes basically according to the amount of space, amount of area that you travel, not according to time. אם ברכת הגומל ובאבל, משום שאם לא כן, ניתת דבריך לשיעורים. Basically, we change the law for each person. Well, like we said, one person can travel by foot, one person by bicycle, and if this guy took him 72 minutes, and the other guy didn't, they'll be doing two different הלכות. And that's not the way of the Torah. שיש שנוסע בעונייה, ויש באווירון, ויש ברכב מהיר, ויש ברכב איתי. וכדי שלא לחלק בין איש לאיש, יש לומר שכביעות החמים, and therefore, so the halakha remains constant. People have to understand that the rules that the guidelines that have been put down are also, for generations. Mahanoseya me'il le'ir b'yamenu, shedirachim mele'ot tenu'a shel mechonot nosim en lebarech gomel. Basically, nowadays, people travel from city to city, and constantly cars on the road don't make gomel. ובזמנים ובמקומות שיש בהם חשש סכנה, חייב לברך הגומל אם נסע מהלך פרסה שהיא כ-4 קילומטר, ונראה לעניות דעתי כתבתי...